On Tuesday, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that states can end affirmative action without violating the Constitution. In a splintered 6-2 ruling, the court said that the Constitution doesn't ban voters in a state from deciding whether public colleges can use race as a factor in school admissions. So what does the ruling mean? In recent years, the Supreme Court has repeatedly ruled that the Constitution doesn't outlaw public colleges and universities from using race in their admissions policies under certain circumstances. But today's ruling would allow voters to say no, that public state institutions should be banned from using affirmative action. What are the ramifications of today's ruling? 8 states have outlawed affirmative action at public colleges, including Florida, California, and Arizona. Tuesday's ruling likely means that those laws will stay on the books. It also gives the green light to voters in other states who might be considering changing their laws to ban the use of affirmative action in public education. What were the rationales behind the decision? Justice Anthony Kennedy, who wrote the lead opinion, ruled that states should have the freedom to tinker with a host of admissions policies, including those that consider race and those that don't. Was the ruling surprising? No, not entirely. The Federal Appeals Court, which first heard the case, largely split along partisan lines back in 2012. Given the U.S. Supreme Court's makeup, with a rough 5-4 split between the conservative and liberal wings, an alternative outcome would have likely been far more surprising.